Hi, welcome to Keith Lemon's Doings. Do likings and do subscribings. This week's Doings, if you don't know what I'm doing, is all Ghostbuster related.
Can you do the theme tune?
Yesterday, which was Sunday, which was the 14th of November, I went to see Ghostbusters Afterlife at Showcase Cinema Deluxe in Bluewater. This is me saying what I'm doing in the car on the way there. Just on my way to Showcase Cinema in Bluewater. Very excited about meeting some Ghostbusters fans, but more specifically excited about watching the film Ghostbusters Afterlife. What I forgot to tell you was I was meeting a guy called David from Proton Props. If you're a Ghostbusters fan, you may have heard of him. He made me the most incredible proton pack. And this is me saying about, this is me meeting him and receiving the proton pack. So I'm here at Showcase and I'm meeting David from Proton Props, who's made a proton pack for us. That's exciting, isn't it? I've not seen it yet. We're going to unveil it under him. Thanks so much for doing
That's
this.
Really appreciate
it. Here it is. Move in so we see all the details. Wow. It's touching. That came on just as I touched it. Just check out all the bits and particles. It's a beautiful thing. It's David to tell us more about it.
So it's all fully loaded with all the special extras you can get with these packs. So it's all got lights and sound all installed in there, but it's also got special things like some smoke effects. So we'll take the wand off and show you what that's all about. So this has all got the lights and sound and all that kind of business going on. So we can switch it on here. And we'll give it a bit of a twist and a pop.
Oh, it's got a twist in.
It has. And then we can fire it as well. So with this as well, we've got a special flash bulb in the end, just like the ones in the movies and everything else, all the lights and sound upon it, look at that. And any moment soon, the smoke should fire up again, but in a different sequence. Also as well with that, so we switch it off.
Oh, and it smells nice.
Toasted marshmallow. And then we'll switch it here, and then on here, and then, you've also got your own mobile disco.
Yes, it plays music. Oh. It is quite heavy, but it's no heavier than carrying like a quite a large dog on your back. Or a bag of taties. A bag of some right nice things. Or a bag of mud. No, it's less heavier than a bag of mud. There it is. Proton Props. Getting all excited about it, I thought I've got to put on my pads and my belt.
Same as what was on the actual original one, so it's a real valve. Same with the pack,
like, isn't it?
Original resistors, vintage ones that are sort of from the 70s and stuff.
I've seen many of these made out of resin.
Yeah. I have seen resin ones.
Yeah, there's lots of resin casts. So I don't use any resin parts, so these are all metal bits on there as well. That's metal in that. So anything that looks metal usually is metal in the ones.
Many metal bits.
Do you still buy anything that comes out like Spirit of Halloween?
There's some bits and bobs I do. Yeah, I do, because for the sort of quality of what you get and the money.
Like the Matty Collector.
Yes. Yeah, I've got some of their goggles and the PKE.
Yeah, I've got those. Yeah.
For what it is, really good.
And then Sideshow brought out version of the trap
in there, got that as well.
Yeah, if you're a Ghostbusters fan, you've probably got the Sideshow ghost trap and the pedal as well. If you haven't, this is me reviewing it ages ago. So on closer inspection, let's take a look at this. From the cult classic sci-fi comedy Ghostbusters, Hollywood Collectibles Group is proud to present the first in our highly anticipated line of official licensed Ghostbusters prop replicas, the Ghost Trap. As with all Hollywood collectible pieces, the museum quality prop replica is constructed of the finest materials, meticulously hand-painted and authentically weathered. Ooh, check out the weathering. What? Back to me and David at Showcase Cinema.
So my first proton pack I made was all cardboard, obviously. You know what I use.
Yeah.
I found a fiberglass shell and stuck cardboard bits to it.
So here it is. Here's the first proton pack that I made. Originally, this was all cardboard. Then I found a fiberglass shell on eBay, which is a bit broken and stuff. This is, I think, 3D printed, the bumper bar and you can see all the glue, and it's not that good. I think the best thing on it is my rainbow cable. It's quite screen accurate. The iron arm here is just some rodding that I got from B&Q, and that is actually foam board there. The clipboard is actually a bottle of something like some air conditioner I got out of the missus's cupboard that she didn't want. The shock mount was a 3D print thing that I got off eBay. More foam board here. Some bits that I got from B&Q. Oh, that looks like it's coming off. Crank knob there that doesn't crank. The thing is with this, it looks quite good. Let me just turn it on. It don't turn on, it don't do anything. I did have some Christmas lights in there, but the battery's corroded and now it is defunct. But it looks quite nice. This would be the Spengler Hasbro wand, which I think is actually fantastic. I think I've reviewed this. Let's switch it on. Oh, there it is. It's exciting, isn't it? And that's all it does. The wand creates the sense that the pack is making the noise, but it's not doing anything. And that was the first pack that I made. A lot of people said, show us your pack. I went, I'll show you my pack, all right. So this Proton pack is the Proton pack that our props department made when we were making the Keith and Paddy picture show when we were doing Ghostbusters. Again, it looks really good. In fact, this one does light up somehow. Can't remember how to switch it on. Where's the switch? It does light up somehow. Somewhere there's a switch. There's no V-hook here. This was held on with Velcro, but that's come off. Because of copyright reasons, we had to change it a little bit. So there's some bits on it that are not screen accurate, but it looks very good. So if someone had gave me this and made this, I would have gone, wow, that's incredible. It doesn't light up on the power cell. The cyclotron area here does light up. And nothing lights up in here. When you're on the telly, you just have to pretend it's all lighting up. But it still looks great. And then we've got the Spirit of Halloween Proton Pack, which I think is a great little thing. It makes noises and has lights. There's no V-hook here, that's junk. That's a bit of fun, isn't it? This is the substitute for the V-hook, which is rubbish. It just keeps falling off. Oh, but I've bought a V-hook off a lovely man on eBay, which I'm gonna bang that on there. I changed the rainbow cable here. This to a more screen accurate one because the one that came on it was rubbish. And I put an iron arm on there. It just, that's gonna fall off really. That's just foam board. I'm so junk. I also put an Alice pack on the back because it makes it more nicer, doesn't it? But let me show you David from Proton Props Proton Pack. Here it is. Cha-ting! Look at this beautiful thing. Everything, right down to the tiniest detail and screen accurate. Look at the texture of this thing. And it's a beast. It's right heavy, but it feels right good on your back. And when you turn it on, it vibrates. Oh, never mind sitting on a washing machine, ladies. Sit on this. Seriously, I absolutely love this though. I feel like my mission to find the most perfect Proton pack is over. Look at this.
I love this texture.
All the metal parts that you can see are metal. He did say there's some resin bits on it somewhere. Look at this. Smoke comes out of there. Let me show you the wand. Is the wand. Now, this was the most surprising thing, how heavy the wand is. Not only is it screen accurate, the crank knob, but you can crank it. The sound is controlled by the crank knob. Turn it up. Or turn it down there. That's good, isn't it? Quite loud as well, so it plays all the tunes from Ghostbusters. You know the tunes. Listen to this. Got spring action here, just like the movie. Here we go. Turn lights down. Listen when you turn it off. So there you have it. If you want the best Proton pack known to man, go to Proton Props. Lovely man called David will sort you out. He sells parts. He'll tell you everything you need to know. And I'm over at Moan. So then I went into the IMAX theatre, which is a wonderful theatre. If you've ever been to an IMAX, you'll know that once you go IMAX, you don't want to go back from IMAX. And introduced Ghostbusters Afterlife. I've been really excited for this. Because of COVID, it got put back, but it's finally here this week. If you're watching this next week, it's finally here last week. If you're watching this next year, it was finally here last year, but it was this week and it was finally here. It was one of the first UK public screenings. All very excited. Met some lovely Ghostbusters people from the Ghostbusters community. And then we sat and watched Ghostbusters Afterlife. I'm not going to give away any spoilers, but it's everything you hope it would be. It really did make me feel like I was a 10-year-old again whilst I was watching it. Who are we kidding? I'm still a 10-year-old. It's art anyway. Yeah, it's a really amazing film. If you haven't seen it, you're going to love it. You've probably seen it by now. Otherwise, you won't be watching this video. Because I guess you're only watching this video because you're a Ghostbusters fan.
Or a Keith Lemon fan.
But yeah, it's a fantastic film. And what a lovely day. And shout out to David from Proton Props. Check him out here. This is his Instagram page. So go check him out. And that's it. Like and subscribe. If you don't see Fruit Week, I'll see Fruit Window. Good luck with your business. Who are you going to call? No, I don't know who you're going to call. Call your mum for all I care. Call. Bye.